You ready to do this? Okay. Hey, everybody, and welcome to Ash Wednesday at Yadkinville United Methodist Church virtually. I am Jonathan Gaylord, the pastor here, and this is Henry, who is helping me out today because I had this whole thing recorded. At least I had the whole introduction recorded and then dropped my external hard drive and lost it. So Henry agreed to help me reshoot it. Which I think you guys will think is much better than just me talking in my office. Henry, do you want to say hello? Don't touch.
Hello.
Good job.
I want to listen to music.
Well, we're not listening to music right now. Hey. There you go. Okay. Our first announcement is that don't bump the microphone.
Hey.
Henry can now hear himself in his headphones, and he's very excited about that. Our first announcement is that you should have received and dropped off at your house a bag that includes some devotional materials, some stickers, but also a small bag of gray or black ash. And you'll need to prepare that ash for this service. And I'd say strongly encourage you to go and do that now. Just hit pause and come back to the service. There's a video that I'll put a link to somewhere around here helping you walk through how to get that bag of ash ready, but make sure you have your little bag of ash prepped and ready to go as we begin this service. The second announcement that I want to make is that throughout Lent, so from now until about April 1st, if you see a flower out in the world anywhere, take a picture of it and send it to me at pastor@yadkinvilleumc.org, and we will use those. Oh, thank you. Should I listen?
Where's my daddy?
Say what?
Where's my daddy?
Look at my daddy? Okay, I'm going to tell the people about flowers really quick. Can I do that? Yeah, ooh, get your baby. That's a good one. So between now and about April 1st, if you see a picture, if you see a flower out in your yard or out when you're walking or at the store or wherever, take a picture of it and send it to me at pastor@yadkinvilleumc.org, and we will use those as part of our Easter worship together. So those are the two announcements that I have. Make sure you've got your ash ready to go, and make sure you take pictures of flowers this Lenten season. And with that, let us move into a time of worship together. I invite you to join with me in our call to worship. I'll read the parts in light and invite you to respond with the parts in bold. Turn away from the calls of worldly success. Repent and turn back to God. Turn away from the desire to have what everyone else has. Repent and turn back to God. Turn away from the greed and the race for power. Repent and turn back to God. As we enter Lent, may we turn back to God. May we seek forgiveness. May we seek healing. May we seek wholeness. May our hearts be renewed in this time of worship. Let us pray. Gracious God, out of your love and mercy, you breathed into dust the breath of life, creating us to serve you and our neighbors. Call forth our prayers and acts of kindness, and strengthen us to face our mortality with confidence in the mercy of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Have mercy on me, O God, according to your steadfast love. According to your abundant mercy, blot out my transgressions. Wash me thoroughly from my iniquity, and cleanse me from my sin. For I know my transgressions, and my sin is ever before me. Against you, you only have I sinned, and done that which is evil in your sight, so that you are justified in your sentence, and blameless in your judgment. Behold, I was born into iniquity, and I have been sinful since my mother conceived me.
Cast me not away from your presence, and take not your Holy Spirit from me.
Behold, you desire truth in the inward being. Therefore, teach me wisdom in my secret heart. Purge me with hyssop, and I shall be clean. Wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow. Make me hear with joy and gladness. Let the bones which you have broken rejoice. Hide your face from my sins, and blot out all my iniquities.
Cast me not away from your presence, and take not your Holy Spirit from me.
Create in me a clean heart, O God, and put a new and right spirit within me. Cast me not away from your presence, and take not your Holy Spirit from me. Restore me the joy of your salvation, and sustain in me a willing spirit, that I will teach transgressors your ways, and sinners will return to you. Deliver me from death, O God, God of my salvation, and my tongue will sing aloud of your deliverance. O Lord, open my lips, and my mouth shall show forth your praise. For you have no delight in sacrifice. Were I to give a burnt offering, you would not be pleased. The sacrifice acceptable to God is a broken spirit, a broken and contrite heart, O God, you will not despise.
Cast me not
in many ways, this Lent feels different than other Lents. The season feels different than years past, partially because we never really left Lent in 2020. We were in the middle of this liturgical church season when the pandemic brought everything screeching to a halt. And so we've never really left Lent 2020. And on top of that, in the midst of this pandemic where we have lost friends and family members, as we have watched hundreds of thousands of our fellow citizens die, as we have watched this pandemic spread across the world and many lose their lives, we have been reminded since last Lent of our own mortality. We have lived through a tumultuous presidential election that revealed once more deep divisions within our community, within our country. And so we enter into this season of Lent very much aware of all of the things that Lent tries to point out to us, very much aware of our own mortality, the frailty of life, our deep, deep sin as individuals and as a community. We are oh so aware of these things. And yet this Ash Wednesday and this Lent, we are invited to become even more aware of those things. And while Lent does invite us to recognize those sins in our lives, to recognize our mortality and our need for God, Lent does something even deeper, something beyond what the news at night can do for us. Lent asks us to hand those sins over to God. Lent asks us to take our hope from ourselves and place it into Christ. And so this Lent, as we enter in once more to the season of fasting and prayer, as we enter once more into a season recognizing our own mortality, our own frailty, our own need for God, may we enter into it, as one pastor says, as an opportunity not to fake it. This year has revealed to us our need for Christ. And maybe for the first time in a long time, we are able to come before God and say, God, I absolutely need you now. So let us give ourselves, our hearts, our minds, our bodies, our souls to Christ, who calls to us, over these 40 days. May we journey with Christ. May we journey with God, who has come to set us free. Amen. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, the early Christians observed with great devotion the days of our Lord's passion and resurrection. And it became a custom of the church that before the Easter celebration, there would be a 40-day season of spiritual preparation. During this season, converts to the faith were prepared for holy baptism. It was also a time when persons who had committed serious sins and had separated themselves from the community of faith were reconciled by penitence and forgiveness and restored to participation in the life of the church. In this way, the whole congregation was reminded of the mercy and forgiveness proclaimed in the gospel of Jesus Christ and the need we all have to renew our faith. I invite you, therefore, in the name of the church, to observe a holy Lent by self-examination and repentance, by prayer, fasting, and self-denial, and by reading and meditating on God's holy word, to make a right beginning of repentance, and as a mark of our mortal nature, let us now kneel before our Creator and Redeemer. We are now at the point in our service when you will need your bag of ashes. If you have not prepared them, hit pause and go and add a little bit of olive oil and mix it into the bag as we prepare to receive the ashes. I would invite everyone to take their ashes in their hand as we prepare to give thanksgiving over them. Almighty God, you have created us out of the dust of the earth. Grant that these ashes may be to us a sign of our mortality and penitence, so that we may remember that only by your gracious gift are we given everlasting life through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. If you are observing the service with family or friends, you can now take your bag of ashes and go around and take turns imposing or drawing a cross on each other's foreheads with the ash. As you do so, you may use the words either, "Remember that you are dust, and to dust you shall return," or you might say, "Repent and believe in the gospel." If you are observing this service alone, you may impose your own cross with those same words, Remember that you are dust, and to dust you shall return. And repent and believe in the gospel. Let us confess our sin against God and our neighbors. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your name. Amen. May the Almighty and merciful God, who desires not the death of a sinner, but that we might turn from wickedness and live, accept your repentance, forgive your sins, and restore you by the Holy Spirit to newness of life. Amen. All things come from you, O God, and with praise and thanksgiving we return to you what is yours. You created all that is, and with love formed us in your image. When our love failed, your love remained steadfast. You gave your only Son, Jesus Christ, to be our Savior, that we might have abundant and eternal life. All that we are and all that we have is a trust from you. And so, in gratitude for all you have done, we offer you ourselves and all that we have. In union with Christ's offering for us, by your Holy Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And now let us pray together as Christ taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Go out into this Lent, knowing that Christ has gone before you, knowing that Christ goes with you, knowing that Christ goes beside you, above you, behind you, and below you. Go knowing that Christ loves you. Go with the blessing of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom. Jesus, remember me. Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom. Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom.